today you have decided to take you on a journey of what a whistleblower is as a whistleblower. But bear in mind, most of the laws don't abide here in South Africa. They only take place overseas on those right countries. So I've just drafted a few notes of what is a whistleblower, what they do, everything. In fact, it's a life of a whistleblower. Okay, as whistleblowers, we abide by certain survival tips, and I'll take you step by step by those tips. I've drafted a few for you here. Firstly, we seek for legal expert. Before we disclose any information, because we're taking risk with what we're doing, because we may put our family in danger, ourselves in danger, or we may disclose messages or knowledge that is not supposed to be disclosed out there. So we always consider consulting an experienced attorney for our communications to be protected at all times. Unfortunately, in South Africa, such things as sebenzi in most cases, whistleblowers are not taken serious. Therefore, we lack organizations that specializes with whistleblowers to help guide us through the process of whistleblowing. When I say through the process, I mean in solidarity, support, wherever it's needed. In other countries, they have those organizations and they offer legal presentation, and they can potentially serve as a bridge between the whistleblower, the recipient, and those who should be benefiting from the message or knowledge of the whistleblower. But we in South Africa, hey, we're not getting such. So we are on our own. If they blow your head for blowing the whistle, you've got no one to talk for you. You have no one to represent you. It's a done deal for you. And blowing a whistle might be one of the difficult yet dangerous professions, especially in South Africa, since we're not recognized as whistleblowers. Though we pray that one day whistleblowers will be recognized and taken seriously. So it can have personal impact on you and your loved ones. Therefore, it is wise to consult them before going forward. It is important to have personal support both from home and your workplace and your surroundings. As a whistleblower, you have to make a plan of everything. Have a strategy for your whistleblowing process so that you're always two steps ahead of those engaging in mixed conduct. However, the plan will need to be adjusted throughout the journey of your whistleblowing, but it will definitely provide you a roadmap to your journey till the end of the road. Be sure if you need to be anonymous or to be public. That one is a very, very important thing, because you must know the importance of being, the advantage and disadvantage of being anonymous, confidential, or being public. There are risk benefits to being anonymous or public. Both, they have risk benefits. For instance, if you remain anonymous, the recipient of your disclosure or the person you're blowing a whistle against cannot follow up going forward of who you are, where you're from, and anything in any form. They can't trace you at all. And then going public may expose you to isolation, public scrutiny, expensive defamation suits. If someone decides to lay charges against you for defamation of character, let's say, for instance, I'm blowing a whistle on the Senzo Meyiwa case for now. If, say, one of those people that I call their names decides to open a case for me for defamation of character, at least I've got something in hand to prove that, yes, These are instances that I've got against them. So it won't be easy for any one of the people who are in the house to go out there and open a case for Sinqobile Maphisa, because I'll issue the copies of 375. I'll take my attorney with, because my attorney is so ready for any of them to press charges against me so that they can reveal or they can expose them. So it's not easy for them to lay charges or do anything of some sort in regards to this. So, So in that manner, you have to be certain if you have to go public, confidential, or anonymous for your safety, your loved one's safety, and the environment's safety. Because, you know, when they're looking for you, they can harass anyone who may know you or your address. So if you go public, you may also be exposed to public scrutiny. Like, you won't be free to go wherever you want to go, because we as the peluti, I've blown a whistle, she's doing this and this, and she's so powerful and got her mafias that might take me down. So you have to be aware of that. Be sure, Uti, your safety is safe all the time. And even life threats. As I once said before, Gutimina, when I started blowing the whistle about this case, I've been receiving threats, calls, messages. And even now, not so long ago, I've been getting calls from a person on Akulum. When I answer the call, they drop. When I call that number back, it says the number does not exist. How possible is that? It's because these people are so powerful. They can have any SIM card they want, send you threats, destroy the SIM card. When you call, the SIM card doesn't exist. When you send the message not delivered, the recipient may be offline. And you're like, this person just called me now. And just now, they're not available. What kind of a mess is that? That's our South Africa with the mafias. Only if we were in the US or other countries where they recognize I'm a whistleblower. Whistleblowers in other countries are given a place of safety all the time. Whistleblowers are recognized. Whistleblowers get compensated for risking their lives and their loved ones' life. But I am Zanzi. In Zanzi, they'll say, "Hi, beka kuluma kakhulu naye. She or he got what he deserves." Imagine, you're fighting corruption, you're saving people's life, you're fighting incompetency, but you'll be told to go to ukuluma kakhulu and you got what you deserve. So those are some of the survival tips that we dwell on. And therefore, these things you really, really need to discuss with your attorney or any advising attorney or whoever, but must be an expert on such. I mean, I've got people, I've told you before, I've got two attorneys on my side. I've got all the legal support I need. Well, when I started this, I didn't have any support. Because I knew what I was talking. That's why even most of my interviews, I'll tell Guti, if I am to die for exposing ukungcola kwabokininda, then be it. If I were to die for crying justice for those five accused, so be it. We all have got our callings. We don't know which is busy anja. So you can't run away from death. Eventually, sonke sofa in the end. So what's the fuss? So you must also know your credibility. Okay, you must also know that your credibility is your greatest asset. Therefore, stick to facts. Don't embellish. Don't embellish at all. Do not exaggerate. When making a disclosure, stick to the information that you're certain and you know to be sound and reliable. You don't know my reliabilities. You don't know how sure am I about that. And then you go out there, you disclose such. We are told in the end, you don't have proof or you don't have any concrete evidence to the information you're disclosing out there. And you have no attorney who advised you. So in such instances, be certain, be sure. I know there are a lot of people that was like, "Hey, it's time to spin this circle. We wish to be like you." Hey guys, it takes courage to be human. who I am. It takes real guts to be a whistleblower because you have to go watching your back every hamba corner. Bege move, who's following you, who's watching you. Okay, when a taxi moto akubuka kakhulu uyaqala uthi ya, this one is an agent of the people I'm disclosing information or knowledge about. Kanti no umuntu wabantu uzibonela umuntu nje wachazeka or ukufanisa somewhere. So be certain of who you disclose and your public scrutiny. Whether you get a first-hand or reliable source, if you doubt it, understate rather than risking exaggerating. Do not embellish, Ntase. Do not at all. Be certain of the information you're sharing out there. Be certain of your resources. Be certain who gives you information and how you portray that information out there. Don't just share any information for sharing, because it is so dangerous to be a whistleblower. And you have to test waters with either trusted colleagues or anyone close to you in order to confirm your concerns for quality control and to identify potential source of solidarity. Be sure, test your information. For example, if you've got an information about a certain police, they are likes of Abusi's page, go to them, send the name, do you know this person? Can you confirm this and this about them? Don't go out there and be like, hey, New Zealand constable Matenjo, he's like this and that, and then when you go out there and publish a story, have concrete or solid evidence against them. You have to also engage in self-care. Always practice self-care and stress-reducing activities, because being a whistleblower, guys, is draining. I'll hear a lot of people who will wish to be me, guys. It's stressing, it's depressing, it's traumatizing, because sometimes someone will be asking you to disclose a certain message for them. Yes, they'll give you all the evidence you need, all the surviving tips for that disclosure, but you have to also keep on exercising, having those distressing activities every now and then throughout the whole whistleblowing process. It is common to experience toxic form of retaliation. Like, there will be fights. So too strong, doesn't mean I've been insulted quite a lot of time. Different people, even about them, pilanam. Deep down, I know what I'm doing. So, from a professional association or gaslighting, which is manipulating someone by psychological means into questioning their own sanity, which can lead to post-traumatic stress disorder, depression. As I said above, it is depressing being a whistleblower. Asondlalo. It's not a child's play. Or even thoughts of harm. You should engage in mindfulness activities almost all the time and develop a community of support through trusted peers, loved ones, therapists, a lot. You have to have that kind of group of support to give you certain support. And please keep on subscribing, guys. The viewers are high, but the subscriptions are low. Let keep on those subscriptions coming. Keep on subscribing. Thank you.